Hello, I am Chef Thierry Levotte from Le Cordon Bleu Ottawa, and I want to say thanks to all of you for joining this evening for the preview of Julia, produced and directed by Academic Award-nominated filmmakers Julie Cohen and Betsy West, who are with me tonight to talk about the film. The film Julia is opening in theater nationwide this month. So for me, I've seen the film and it's really impressive. All the research, all the interview you have done, all the document you bring it is very, very interesting. I think it will stay as a masterpiece of American culinary history because really Julia Child has been something so important in culinary in state. Actually, I didn't know her since I was about 21 years old. Because I'm a book collector, so I found a book of Julia Child in France, and it was costing like 4,000 euro. And I was so surprised that I start to investigate and to see what was happening about that woman. And I found all the story, and it was really, really amazing. But I think you make a lot of more research than me because I see the film. So I would like to pass some question. Julia Child plays such a monumental role in paving the way for women in culinary industry. What made you interested in doing the documentary on her?
We were so eager to tell Julia Child's story. She had such a monumental impact, really, on American culture, how Americans thought not just about cooking, but about eating. I think it might be a little bit hard to understand from outside the country how dismissive Americans were towards food at a certain point. And Julia really changed that. We also just love the idea of digging into the food world as the ambience of a story. And we should say that coming and spending a day at the Cordon Bleu was really a highlight of the making of this film. Such a thrill for us to do.
Okay. So many of today's culinary leaders are featured throughout the film, offering commentary on Julia and her life. What it look working with them on hearing how she impact their life?
We were really surprised in a way to learn that Julia is so revered even by a younger generation of chefs in America who understand what a turning point it was when Julia Child wrote Mastering the Art of French Cooking and then went on American television and started to teach people about good food. And the chefs of today, even though they aren't necessarily classical French chefs, they really do understand how much they owe to Julia. So that was really fun. And it was especially fun as Julie said, we went to France. We spent a day at Cordon Bleu. When we were there, we interviewed André Cointreau to give us the history of Cordon Bleu and to really understand what it meant for Julia Child to go there after World War II and to talk her way into the professional class where all the other students were men. And also, he was very interesting talking about what a kind of macho world the French cooking world was that Julia basically invaded a little bit, as was Danielle Delpouche, the chef who famously was the first woman to cook for a French head of state. And so we got a real picture of what food means to French people and how Julia fell in love with that and worked so hard to learn her craft in France. That was just, fantastic for us.
Okay. What was one of your favorite things you learned about Julia's life?
We really loved the fact that Julia didn't find her passion until she was in her 30s and really didn't have her big success until she was in her 50s. This is a woman who is such a superstar in America who never appeared on television until age 50. And the idea of her really blooming at that late stage in life, particularly through her love of food and her expertise, not only in the preparation of food, but really in teaching. She had a knack for explaining things in a way that they didn't seem intimidating to people. So I think we just loved learning about that. You know, when you think of somebody becoming a star, often you're talking, especially a woman, often you're talking about an ingenue. And Julia was something quite different, and we love that part of her story.
Julia had many recipes. How did you choose which recipe to make and focus on the film? Did you try some of them?
We did try. We did. We were, you know, it was during the lockdown. And so Julie and I were in our separate homes working virtually, but we were also cooking for our respective husbands and, you know, trying out Julia's recipes as best we could. That was a good experience. We particularly loved the salad niçoise. Which isn't that difficult to cook, but it's not that hard. You know, beef bourguignon, you know, some of the classic Julia dishes. I was gonna ask, I mean, you discovered Julia, you said, you were 21 years old when you found her book and you thought, why is it so expensive? I mean, we discovered in France, really not a lot of people know about Julia. Is that still the case? Yeah.
It's still the case, actually. Yeah. Nobody know about her. And it's very strange because when you see everything she make for the French cuisine, actually, instead, I cannot understand how we cannot recognize her. She mérite the Légion d'honneur, like we say in France.
Yeah.
For all the things she show from France.
Well, but the Cordon Bleu certainly celebrates her. I mean, it was sort of fun to be there and to see the picture of Julia Child there. And they certainly feel a connection with Julia.
Yeah. With Le Cordon Bleu, there is always a connection because it's one of the first woman who graduated. So it's something very important for us. And it's something that's still in the story. And when you can see on the wall of Le Cordon Bleu in Paris or all the Cordon Bleu, you will find the name of Julia Child always.
Yeah.
And when you look at the recipes that are in Mastering the Art of French Cooking, do they seem to do justice to the French way of cooking? Or can you tell that part of it has an American influence, or does it feel like pure French cooking?
No, actually, when you look at the recipe, you see the very classic French training that she has. And she followed it quite well. Sometimes she had a little things, but what I really appreciate on her book is how precise it was. I think it's one of the first book that you can see really all the ingredients, all the step, all the cooking timing, and everything is very, very well explained on her book. And that is one of the first book I could see that it was so precise because usually the French book on that time of a country, because I have 5,000 cuisine book in my house. So imagine, and I nearly read all of them.
Yeah.
So it's a lot. And I can tell you they was not so precise. And I think it's one of the first that, as she was not a chef, like she say, oftentimes, she don't want to be recognized as a chef because she haven't been working in a kitchen, but she was still a chef. But She want to share what she knows. Yeah, really, she want to share. She don't hide anything. And that's something that changed on this book, on her book, actually.
Yeah. Yeah, we love that someone in our film talks about it. It's as if Julia is there with you, step by step, you know, telling you what to do, which is a big difference from the cookbooks in America, which were pretty skimpy cookbooks, and they often featured mixing various canned or frozen or mixes. I mean, they really didn't go into the basics and to enjoy the satisfaction of creating something from scratch.
Yeah, that's something she brings the cuisine with love, like I say. She was so in love with the cuisine, with the cooking, the way to start the beginning, to find the ingredient, that she was able to make something different. And really for that, she go in the head of all Americans, actually. So one more question. There have been many pieces of work done of Julia Child, her career and her life. For both, what set this beautiful piece of culinary art apart from all the other ones?
Well, we think by telling Julia's story as a documentary feature film, firstly, it really allows us to tell so much of this story in Julia's own voice. We were able to find not only so much archival material from her shows and the behind the scenes filming and photographs, but also dozens of audio interviews in which Julia's telling her own story. The other thing that we're able to add because of the magic of modern cinematography is taking these classic Julia recipes that we're preparing quite authentically, but then filming them with incredibly high-end cameras so that it really, you know, if you look at the old Julia shows from public television, she's very entertaining and she's teaching well, but the food actually does not look so good because it's in, you know, it's in standard definition. Sometimes it's in black and white. Even when it's in color, the color isn't so great. So we feel like our cinematographers and editors really help us bring the food to life in all of its glory. And the only thing that, you know, the only thing the film doesn't let you do is eat it. So we're suggesting that people make dinner reservations immediately following viewing.
And I should add that our cinematographers, one was in America, and we had created a Julia replica kitchen and had the dishes prepared by Susan Spungen, the food stylist. And she, you know, very accurately prepared all these dishes, and our cinematographer Claudia Raschke was filming them here in New York. But we also worked with a wonderful French cinematographer, Nanda Bredelard, who really specializes in food photography, and he uses, you know, macro shooting and slow motion, and it's so artistic. It's sometimes you can't even tell that it's food, you know. It's just so, it's so beautiful. And you know, we felt that's something that we could bring to this project.
Yeah, actually the photo in the film are amazing. There is some macro shooting that wow, you really want to take it on and eat it. I remember that tomato falling down on the black table.
Yes, but it comes
it's
down.
Just amazing that so if Julia was here today, what's one burning question you had while putting together the film?
You know, Julia was such an optimistic person who was always looking ahead, always just greeting the next day and what can I do? And that's true really throughout her life. She had her success in middle age, and then she was on television well into her 80s. And part of that was, I think, because of her optimism and her just always looking forward, making connections with younger people, younger chefs. I think one of the things we might want to ask Julia about were the more discouraging times and oops. That's okay. I'll pick that up. I mean, I think one of the things we'd want to ask Julia about was how she got through the more discouraging times in her life, when her 12-year effort to write this masterpiece cookbook was rejected by a publisher. You know, when she faced challenges, how did she get through that? I don't know. She was so positive thinking, whether or not she would reflect on that, but we might push a little bit.
Yeah. I'm sure it was a very difficult moment when the book was rejected.
Yeah.
So many efforts, so long, and is something that is not easy. So you have to go again and try to make it another way. And
yeah.
But you see, she was a hard worker. She came back and the same on the recipe is not working once. You try another time, until you get something really perfect and you are ready to sell it.
you know, I wanted to ask you, Chef, do you think that the culinary world has changed for women since Julia's day? How much have kitchens opened up and become less of a sort of macho world that we describe in the film?
Yes, it changed a lot, but if we take a little bit the story, on about the 1930 in France, we have somebody what he was called Eugénie Brézier, and she was a woman who had 6-star Michelin. He was the first woman or the first person in the world to have 6-star Michelin. And until 1998, but Alain Ducasse get it as well. So imagine, at the beginning, it was a woman who was in a cuisine. It was like we say in France, les mères lyonnaises. Lyon is one of the parts of France, yeah, where we are more very good chef, like you know. And usually all the restaurants, the bistro was with a woman behind. So La Mère Brasier was the first one to get 6-star Michelin. After, as it started to become art, more and more men was going there and try to be in the front. Because as soon as it started to be art, it was more like, let's say, macho time on the men was going there.
Yeah.
So everything changed after a little bit when Julia Child was able to make all that kind of thing. We can see women coming after, but it's still difficult for them. It's okay. We can still see, we can take the name of Arzac in Spain, for example, that the father of the three-star, he was the first one to get 3-star Michelin, and now he get a step back, but Hélène, the daughter, have plenty problem to get on the top and to be respected by the men. Now she get it, but it take a long time because we are not used to see a woman in a restaurant as well. We can take Anna Sophie Pic the same in France. The father was a very well-known chef and she have problem to get over. So little to little, we have more and more people that going up, women that are going up. And that's very good actually, because they have another sensibility. Instead, we have my neighbor actually, Dominique Crène, that she get a 3-star Michelin as well. And she's very strong character and make a very, very good job and impressive. So everything changed. She helped all the women to go up. Julia Child open the way for a lot of people and give sample to a lot of people.
That's good to hear.
So Julia have a very big impact as well, actually, when she started, because all the world was going out of the warm, the second warm, and all the industry was based actually at this moment for the military. So they tried to make frozen things, manufactured things, and everything. So after that, the woman, mostly in the state, was using that kind of product because with the publicity of the fancy woman waiting for the men arriving at home, opening the freezer and just eating the food.
Yes.
It was the typical publicity we can see on the TV. She makes a big change because she makes people loving food, actually. That was really, really the big change she makes. Oh, it's so easy. She makes it so easy. There is no complication with the explanation she was giving step to step. Everybody was able to reproduce it. And people start to think that they can play with food as well, to make it with the children. That is something that is always very interesting to teach them and to go ahead. So that was something very interesting. But that is something she found in France, because actually in France with food, we don't play, I say, always. We are very serious. We like that conviviality that we have around the table, but we have always a very long dinner, very long lunch. We are used to be 3-4 hours on the table. We start with the aperitif. we start to speak on everything. And she take that way, she understood that way that we have, and she tried to communicate it in a TV program she have actually. And she make it very well. She was funny as well. And for me, one of the big things she had is she was a woman that was able, you see her on TV and you think, oh, it could be me.
Yeah, it could be me.
And that's really the good point she had, with the point of fun that she had sometimes, and with all the things. Allez, let's start, bam, the chicken, or the, the roast chicken on the table there. Yeah. And it was quite funny thing that she was doing.
Yes, you know, many of the people that we interviewed said the same thing over and over. When they watched her show, they thought, if she can do it, then I can do it too. And, you know, that's a really empowering thing, because people thought of making French food as just being beyond them because of the difficulty factor. But Julia gave people a little courage. And as you say, really showed the joy. I don't think she completely converted Americans to a situation where, particularly in the middle of the day, where we would take a 2-hour lunch and really savor the food. But she helped bring that value and an understanding that, you know, spending time with people savoring good food is worth doing. And we couldn't agree more.
Yes, and you see that the people was looking at the TV when it was her time show. People was going to see, waiting for it, and when they take it out, they want more, and so she can find another TV to make it. I was just wondering one thing. If at that time there was Instagram, Facebook, and everything, how many followers she can get?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, a lot.
Oh, wow. It's, you know, she would definitely be up there in the social media stratosphere, no question. But the one thing that a number of people have said to us that Julia wouldn't have done would be taking pictures of her plate when it's served to her. Because Julia's whole attitude, and she said this was a French thing, so maybe you can tell us if this is true, but Julia had a rule, which was, when your meal is served, you eat it.
Yes, because, you know, one of the most frustrated things that you see in a restaurant, actually, the chef tried to make the plate at the right temperature.
Yeah.
So you prepare everything to have it hot or warm or whatever is it. But you put it on the table and you see 80% of the people actually are making a photo.
Yeah.
Yes.
And everybody is making the same
and
photo.
And how does that feel as the chef?
Yeah, what's that like?
So bad. Actually, so bad, because, you know, the people are taking the photo, but they are not interested in the food. They don't taste even the food. They just want to have a nice picture to say, I've been there.
Right.
And for us as a chef, what we feel is that the food is the most important.
Yeah.
It's not the photo. And
right.
If we see the photo of Julia Child, they are not nice. There is plenty, even the size of the plate on some photo, you can see it's a little bit dirty and everything, but the most important is the food. The flavor that you can get in your mouth when you taste the food is not really the presentation. But now everybody is focusing on the presentation, and I can see here in Le Cordon Bleu, actually, even we get that problem. The student wants the Instagram photo before to learn the base. They don't want to learn the base. They really want to make the Instagram photo. And I tell them, you can make the best photo that you want, but if you don't have taste in your plate, nobody is going to come back.
Yeah. Well, Julia would be completely on board with that attitude. It's about the food and enjoying the food.
Yeah, it's the most important. And when you see the restaurant that follow for years and years, it's always because you have something in your plate that is very, very good.
Yeah.
Because fashion go, they can go, they can make something for 1-2 months, 1 year, but after they disappear, they are not anymore on the scene. So it's really what you have in the plate that you need.
Well, it was so fantastic to talk to you, chef, and to hear, you know, your reflections on Julia and the fact that you discovered Julia as a young man. I just love that, finding her book, and it's great. Thank you for talking to us.
Later on, I bought the book because at that moment I didn't have money to buy it, but later on I bought it I have it in my house.
It's one of the best-selling books of all time.
Yeah, it's the wall, and not only instead, it's in the wall.
Yeah, exactly.
It's impressive.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.